say good morning or shall I say just say hello friends. It is a pleasure to be talking to you. I wanted to be there personally to welcome you all. I have been there most of the times, but this time it has just so happened that I have not been able to visit Ghaziabad. Distances are increasing, but you know, definitely one must utilize technology to communicate still the message and the pride you know, one actually feels in being an alumni of IMT. I was the pass out of the third batch, 82 to 84, and I remember when I joined IMT, at that point in time it was not even recognized as equivalent to MBA. It was you know, almost one-tenth the size and the facilities which you have at this point in time, and still I remember that batch of ours had lot of you know, spirit, and you know, I remember that we went and fought in the office of the DTC to say that the bus stop outside IMT should be called the IMT bus stop and not the Ingram bus stop. I really do not know as to whether you know, now it is called an IMT bus stop or not, but never mind, that was a small issue. IMT has really come a long way since that time. You know, now there are campuses in Nagpur, there's a campus in Dubai, there's a campus in Hyderabad. The distance learning you know, also is doing extremely well. Of course, you know, there are always challenges in expanding one's you know, branches, and then making sure that everybody lives up to the same quality, and you know, it takes time to come up. I remember you know, during our time I was very, you know, passionate about marketing, and most of the 2 years we didn't have actually a marketing professor, but yet I, you know, went on through my own you know, kind of passion for marketing to win a lot of accolades during my professional career of serving you know, other organizations. But to tell you very frankly, I think ultimately, you know, life gives a lot of opportunities to every one of us. I think at every you know, passing out from a school or a college or an institution, there is always another new starting point. And as you stand or sit here together, you know, it is the beginning of another journey for you. The next 2 years are going to be you know, massive in terms of the impact they will have on your life. You have kind of, you know, gone up the pyramid a bit, where only, you know, a certain level of intellect, a certain level of commitment, dedication, and you know, passion to excel is very, very important to arrive at that at this stage. And the competition, or you know, the atmosphere around you would no longer be as easy, you know, as it was back in the college, at other places, you know, and suddenly you will find that maybe you were the star in your previous school or college, and here you will find, you know, that there are so many stars who are equal to or better than you. But I think that is what life is all about. You know, as you keep progressing, you know, kind of, and if you want to progress, that is, you know, if you want to grow, that you know, you have to continuously learn and be very, very inquisitive, passionate about things. Whatever you learn at the you know, institute, I'm sure that is going to be tremendous, of tremendous advantage. But also make sure that you interact with the industry, and there are lots of you know, projects which have been taken up by the institute. In fact, when I founded the Alumni Association, that was way back, you know, in 2006, I think, about 5 years ago now. We started with, you know, almost practically no database which was existing. At that point in time, we were about 7,500 strong alumni. but hardly people knew where they were, you know, so we went about searching the old records and made, you know, chapter chairs, we made batch chairs, you know, so every batch should actually complete their database, every city we should have a chapter, and we also took a lot of initiatives which were in terms of making sure that live projects or live industry projects come to the students. You know, at Milagro itself, I've you know, gone ahead and signed an MOU with the IMT on small businesses and small entrepreneurship, and you know, these experiences are tremendous. You know, if you have a hands-on experience along with the theory which you are learning, and keep on, you know, kind of superimposing and keep on drawing from the practical experience or from the theoretical learning into the practical experience, I think as you are doing your MBA or doing your professional course, whatever you have chosen, I think it is the most wonderful this thing, because even the live project you can do as a student, if you pass out, and as you pass out, you know, that right or privilege of a student will go. The difference between a student and a professional is that student can afford to make mistakes and a professional cannot afford to make mistakes. Many a times a professional is not even forgiven for making, you know, small mistakes. And who knows, you know, whether you are going to be a professional or whether you are going to be an entrepreneur. If you are going to be an entrepreneur, I think the time is right. There is so much which is happening around India today. And there is such an ecosystem which is building. You know, I remember when we, you know, passed out, there were hardly any choices. My first job was, you know, at 1560 rupees, I still remember, with a company called Oneida, which was, you know, in a small shed in Okhla industrial area. And there were no choices. I went out, you know, got another job. But when I joined Oneida, of course, there was a winning atmosphere, and I continued there for almost 9.5, 10 years. And, you know, I still remember, before I started my own organization, which is Milagro, I was one of the highest paid executives, you know. So as you know, take very important decisions about your life, never put money as the most important criterion for joining an organization or starting a business. Because if you have passion for something, if you have you know, a liking for an industry or a particular organization, I'm sure that if you add value, if you work hard, money is just the fruit, you know, which will come. But the real you know, work is basically, you know, in terms of building capabilities and learning, which is at the root of everything, almost like a tree, you know. And then the trunks are the processes which you follow, and the, you know, the branches are the customers or you know, the infrastructure which you have. And if you do these things very well, which is the capability building, if you are setting up your own organization, maybe people building, attracting people, putting you know, them together, you know, then structuring their thought process in a, you know, proper policies, procedures, etc. in the organization, and, you know, making sure that the customers are satisfied. Customers can be internal customers, external customers, they can be, you know, business partners for you, or any stakeholder. And if you take care of them, you know, financial result actually is a foregone conclusion. Entrepreneurship, you know, demands tremendous amount of commitment and knowledge, and more important than anything else, I think, result orientation. I think the difference many a times which I have seen, you know, being very stark, you know, in people who will be entrepreneurs or can be entrepreneurs is, you know, their ability to sift through a lot of unnecessary, you know, tasks or jobs or things which get created around an issue. And they say, okay, go for the kill. You know, this is how the best path is going to be there. They have a vision. I'm not saying that an entrepreneur should necessarily take shortcuts, you know, or should just, you know, want to be effective and not efficient or follow the right processes. I'm only saying that unnecessary processes, non-value adding things, I think an entrepreneur does not do. I'm sure that these 2 years are going to be tremendous learning, as I said, and you know, of massive importance and impact on your life. Make the most of it. I wasn't able to be there this time. I'm sure I will be able to meet you during the year, and I wish you lot of success, lot of happiness, and may you work together to make this IMT brand grow by leaps and bounds. And not only Ghaziabad, please cooperate with other centers also together to make it happen. Maybe they need the support of IMT Ghaziabad. Make it happen. Thank you.